Endeavour Houston, we see a nominal MECO. Welcome to space.
Hello there, Simply Space fans. It's been a while since my last video, and that's because I've been working on development of my new Android game, Manual Docking. I've got a short video to break the hiatus for you. Here's a look at what I think is a very cool and very interesting mechanism. It's the Canadarm Latching End Effector. Canadarm was the robotic arm extending from the space shuttle's payload bay to move astronauts around on EVAs, grab satellites like Hubble for servicing, and assemble the modules of the International Space Station. Today, Canadarm 2 is in service on the International Space Station for all sorts of tasks, most notably for capturing and berthing cargo supply craft like Dragon 1, Cygnus, and HTV. The very end of the Canadarm is what I want to show you. It's called the Latching End Effector, and it's the actual grabbing part of the arm. The Latching End Effector can grab onto objects that have a grapple fixture. Grapple fixtures look like this. They all have a flat base plate, a grapple pin with a small ball on the end, and on the base plate around the pin there are these three ramped bars to provide additional rotational stability once grappled, and there is a small targeting pin to help astronauts controlling the arm align it using a camera. The Latching End Effector features a carriage with a rotating ring inside it. This ring has three snare wires attached to it, such that when the ring rotates, it closes the snare. The rest is pretty simple. To grapple an object, the Latching End Effector is moved over the grapple pin. The ring rotates, closing the snare over the pin, then the snare carriage retracts into the Latching End Effector, pulling on the ball at the end of the grapple pin until the snare wires are taut and there is a good interface between the Latching End Effector and that base plate. You can see that the three ramps that I mentioned earlier are positioned in three notches in the Latching End Effector to help stabilize the grapple fixture rotationally. The grapple fixture you see right now would be an example of a flight releasable grapple fixture, or FRGF. It's the simplest type of grapple fixture, and it's the type that Dragon 1 uses. It's for when you don't need to hold on to something for too long and you don't require connecting power and data to it. But when you do, you will need a PDGF. That's a power and data grapple fixture. These are more advanced grapple fixtures that are actually used to attach Canadarm 2 to the ISS. You see, Canadarm 2 has a Latching End Effector at both ends. PDGFs have these four cutouts in the base plate with flaps over them, and inside them are electrical connection points that Canadarm 2 can interface with. Once the grappling like we've seen so far is finished, latches from the Latching End Effector will extend out and latch into these cutouts on the PDGF. Then connectors will extend and connect into the power and data sockets located inside the cutouts. There are PDGF grapple fixtures located at a variety of places on the US segment of the International Space Station. This is very useful as it allows Canadarm 2 to be positioned at any of them as required. If you didn't already know about grapple fixtures and the Latching End Effector, I sure hope you found this quite enlightening, because it's a really cool mechanism. If you're a fan of Simply Space, I'd highly encourage you to consider supporting me over on Patreon, where you can get access to our exclusive Discord community, early behind-the-scenes renders and preview animations, and early access to my game, Manual Docking. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to check out the Space Shuttle's payload, and I'll catch you later.